Hey guys, what's going on? It's Overlord Tico here, bringing you guys a video of Magic the Gathering Duels of the Planeswalker 2013, otherwise shorter name known as Magic 2013. And I've actually gone ahead and spent the last pretty much full day just playing this game, so this is why I have not uploaded any videos aside from the two uploaded previously of this game, Magic 2013. And I just want to talk a little bit about, when I started playing Magic. And this was actually a long time ago. I think I started playing Magic all the way back in my sophomore year of high school. And this was a long time ago. This was at least like 7-8 years ago. And the last time I played Magic was officially, the last official time I played Magic was officially 5 years ago. I only played Magic for about two years. And when I was playing Magic, I actually didn't have that many cards. I actually played off the scraps that my friends gave me. You know, I actually had a bunch of friends that they used to play a lot of Magic every single day. And this was along the time that Yu-Gi-Oh! And Magic were both right, pretty much going up against each other, because Yu-Gi-Oh! Was rising up and I was playing a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh! Then I noticed that some of my friends were playing Magic, and I was like, you know, that game looks interesting, so let me go ahead and try it out. And that's exactly what I did, and I tried it out, and I actually gotta say, you know, Magic was actually pretty good back at the time. But since I didn't have the extra money, since I was spending already money on Yu-Gi-Oh cards and stuff, you know, to go into Yu-Gi-Oh tournaments, I didn't have money to spend on Magic, so I just played off the scraps that my friends gave me, and somehow I managed to, like, you know, build a pretty decent deck, at least I would say, from those scraps my friends gave me. And I mainly played rat ninjas and human ninjas. At the beginning, when I started playing Magic, I usually try to stick to only playing the human ninjas, the blue ninjas. And then after a while, I started playing the rats, and then I decided to combine them, since I figured both of them would actually work a little bit better together, you know, because rat ninjas, they focus more on actually killing the monsters and discarding opponent's cards from his hand whenever they inflict damage. And the human ninjas were focused more on whenever they inflicted damage, you would draw more cards or bounce your opponent's cards back to his hand. You know, that way he would have to, like, waste mana having to summon them again and everything. So, you know, that was around the same time I got really big into Yu-Gi-Oh, started playing Yu-Gi-Oh a lot. And I guess I played for about 2 years, and until my senior year in high school was when I actually stopped playing Magic. Around that time, I kind of slowed down on my Yu-Gi-Oh as well. I was actually more concentrating on your school. That was also around the time I started on YouTube. It was around 2007-2008 era. That's when I really got big on YouTube and started making videos on YouTube every day. So I slowed down on Yu-Gi-Oh. I pretty much completely stopped playing Magic. That's what it was, like, 5 years ago. And I slowed down on Yu-Gi-Oh. I started playing a lot of chess in school. I joined the chess team, and I was second board in my chess team in my school, and we got second place in our in our area. I was the only person in my team that actually didn't lose against the team that got, you know, the school that got first place in my area. I think I was playing second board. When we played against them, I was the only one who won from my team, from all five boards. You know, second board was the only one that won. I'm a beast. I was beasting. But, you know, going back to Magic, I really didn't touch Magic anymore since, like, 5 years ago. I actually went ahead, and my cousin, about 3 years ago, he found some Magic the Gathering cards, and he didn't know what to do with them, since he knew I like card games. He went ahead and gave me those cards, and he didn't even know what they were. And then when he gave them to me, I was like, oh, that's cool. You know, I used to have these cards. So that was about 3 years ago. And about 2 years ago, I decided to go to a random Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournament, you know, just to see if I still had it, I guess. And when I went to the tournament, I saw that everybody had this big, they had a concession stand full of, like, trading card games and stuff like that. And there was a bunch of Magic cards. So I went ahead and bought a few Magic cards, and, you know, just to have them. Just to be like, you know, if someday I ever get back into playing Magic, then I'll have some of the cards in real life that I used to have back in the day that I actually really liked, you know, like some ninjas. So I went ahead and bought some ninja cards, and, you know, I still got them right there in my drawer, you know, just chilling right next to my Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Actually, I don't even got that many. I got maybe like 100 Magic the Gathering cards. You know, that's pretty much just like a little small background story to, like, my Magic experience and how I began playing Magic. And, you know, I'm actually not that familiar with all the abilities and stuff, so that's actually kind of helpful that I played this game. And this game actually kind of, like, sparked up that interest again. And, you know, it's actually a cheaper way of playing the game, you know, because you can play people online, you can build your decks, you know, compete and stuff like that without having to spend an arm and a leg on it. Because, you know, like, packs in real life cost like $3-4 a piece. And this game cost me $9.99, and I've already spent, like, pretty much like 24 hours playing it. Because I slept like 9 hours, but between after those 9 hours, I spent like 12 hours playing, and then next 12 hours playing after I woke up. So I've spent pretty much like 24 hours already, and I already got like 80-something% of the trophies complete. And I just got to complete the challenges now in this game. So, you know, just some small little things right there, here and there. But anyways, guys, that's pretty much all the commentary I got for you guys for this video. And, you know, just bringing you guys some more Magic the Gathering videos. I actually got about 30-something Magic the Gathering videos recorded. I'm not sure if I'll actually show videos of all of them or if I'll just show them without commentary. But some of them are actually interesting, like my first time facing some people or some duels I found pretty interesting or something, you know. I'll try to beat my previous video doing the overkill, negative 189 damage and 191 damage in one turn. I'll try to like up that one up by maybe like 999 damage, hopefully, which I think is actually quite possible. So anyways, that's pretty much all this for this video, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed this, and I will be catching you guys later. Peace out.